On this episode of Bobscaping, we're back to do some driveway sealing. We probably get more comments about driveway sealing videos than any others. There's quite a bit of debate about what causes cracks, how to seal them, when to seal them, what to use, etc., etc. This year we're going to patch up this old driveway with some optimum latex right from Home Depot. So, I'll try to put some clips on here of the procedure. I'm going to do some power washing, get some of the dirt off the driveway first, then seal some of the major cracks, let them dry, and then put a finish coat of sealer on the entire driveway. Thanks for watching the Bobscaping channel. Hope you enjoy this. Okay, here's our trusty old Hurricane power washer. We got the water turned on, and it always helps to release some pressure, keep it off while you're trying to start the power washer. Is to clean out the cracks without knocking any more material loose. Notice that's a different technique than when you clean wood, because we don't stand any chance of leaving marks on the asphalt, whereas we do with wood. Here's the patched area we did several years ago. As you can see, it's holding well. Of course, the area around it is full of alligator cracks and even some deeper cracks. But yeah, the patch itself has held well. We get a lot of questions about that, so we're looking good there. Okay, got all the power washing done. We're looking at some of the larger cracks. These are the ones that usually need special filler, or where I usually mix in extra sand. You definitely want to seal them first and then wait a day and do your main driveway sealing. When you get down to the finer ones, the alligator cracks, a regular coat of sealer will usually take care of them. So tomorrow morning we'll sweep out any remaining puddles, actually try to get those out today and get it all dried off. And it's always easiest to seal early in the morning when it's cool out and the asphalt is still cool, and that way it doesn't dry as fast and it tends to spread better. All right. Once you open your sealer, you usually find it has settled out and separated with more of the solids and heavier material going to the bottom of the bucket. So I always like to take a drywall bit. This is the style I have, and put it on the end of a most powerful drill you have. And since the bucket's so full, you want to use on and off motions when mixing, in an attempt not to overflow the bucket. After a bit, you'll notice when it's mixed enough to begin using the product. Okay, so we got our first bucket of sealer out here. I like to pour a small puddle and just use a brush. It's about, what, a 6-inch wide brush, kind of a cheap one, but we've gotten a lot of use out of it. And just put a little excess sealer there and work it down over your crack so it can fill in. Then you go back and go back and forth. And just for your worst alligator crack areas, do that. I didn't add any grit to this. It does have some grit in it, not very much. I like adding the grit because it gives it a little more bulk and it doesn't shrink quite as much when it dries. So I'm going to continue on and do this first kind of crack seal, I guess you'd call it. And then tomorrow we'll do the main sealing. So here we are looking at some of the cracks that we filled yesterday with just the regular sealer. And as you can see, there's been shrinkage. In other words, where the sealer contracts as it dries, which is one of the reasons to add sand, because that helps give it more bulk. And when the shrinkage occurs, it's not as great. So you can see we did all those cracks. Coming down here, we see this is the patch we did a few years ago that there's so much consternation about. You can see it's great. Of course, there's a lot of alligatoring and cracking of the asphalt around it. So again, these efforts are mostly to try to keep this driveway basically glued together and prevent the big expense of replacement. So the plan is just to seal it every year or two and spend $100 instead of the big money. All right, let's get busy sealing. We're just about ready to start sealing. The next step will be using a leaf blower to clean off any leaves that have fallen on the driveway overnight. And that's one advantage to sealing your driveway in early fall as opposed to when the leaves are falling off the trees and getting into your sealer. As we seal, I like these. This is kind of a professional grade brush that we used to seal with back in the days. We used to seal a lot of driveways. I'm not sure where they're available. This is what we bought at Home Depot. This is the sealer we're going to use. And it's always good to carry a damp rag in your pocket to help keep your hands clean. And I also like to keep one clean side on the bucket. When you pour out small puddles out of one side of the bucket, drop your handle down to the other side and try to keep it clean. That helps keep your hands clean. All right, time to get going here. It's early morning, air's cool, sun's not heating up the driveway yet. You want to keep your bucket where you won't trip over it. You tend to put it behind you and it's easy to back into it. Here you can see I've placed a couple puddles, and of course, this driveway has a lot of irregularities like this dip over here. So you have to basically seal going back and forth instead of up and down. So let's see what that looks like. And we'll get this edge over here. You want to have enough of a bead to make it flow, but not so much that it gets any place it's not supposed to. Okay, draw it along there. And then brush marks are mostly style points, but you definitely don't want to have areas that are with thicker accumulations than others. They don't dry the same and may create some issues, but yeah, basically I like to use a back and forth sweeping motion like that, and then go back before you get too far and just make sure you didn't miss any areas, or work it back in a little bit, get rid of your brush marks. Okay, so that gives you an idea of how I like to do it. I know a lot of the guys that do this for a living, guys and gals, will even walk in the sealer, but I try not to walk in it. Partly it's because it's slippery, and plus you get all of your shoes. Of course, anything you're wearing to do this is what I would call throwaway clothing. All right, so here we are about 6 hours later. The sealer's dry enough to walk on. You can see how the cracks have shrunk. So I have about a half a bucket left, so I might work on those a little bit more. And other than that, it looks good. I wanted to mention too, you always have to be cautious about splashing. When I was pouring a puddle of sealer here, I poured a puddle and then added more to it, which caused it to splash on the fence. So that's a little more serious when it's your garage door or something like the brick next to your house. So, okay. For this episode of Bobscaping, this is Bob.